All right, welcome to Dude with a Microscope. In this series, I am going to be introducing you to the always fascinating, sometimes shocking, world of the microscopic. The stuff around us and inside of us that we cannot see without the aid of microscopes. Today, we are going to look at the hair of a porcupine, otherwise known as a quill. Yes, a quill is just a hair, but it's got some little differences or adaptations that make it pokey. Now, this one is from a North American porcupine. It's about as long as a toothpick, probably 2 inches long or so, about as thick as a toothpick. Are porcupine quills a lot sharper than your hairs? Well, a microscope can help you really see the tip well. I've put a porcupine quill right next to one of my hairs so that you can see the tips. Now, I don't know about you, but it doesn't really look like it's a lot sharper. But wait, if your hairs are as sharp as a porcupine's quills, why doesn't it hurt when you touch the tips of your hairs? They may be sharp, but they are soft. They are thin and flexible, so when you touch those hairs, they bend. What makes a quill so pokey is not really how sharp it is, it's more about how thick it is. That makes it rigid or hard, and it stays straight when you poke the tip. It doesn't bend very easily. You can bend it a little bit, but it stays straight when you touch the tip, and that allows it to poke into that animal. If we look a little bit closer through this microscope at that brown tip there, you will see that there are tiny little scales that lay down over top of each other and point toward the root end of the quill, away from the tip. That makes them drive in more easily, and it makes them stick in so that when the porcupine moves away, the quill stays in that unfortunate animal and slips out of the porcupine. When we look at the roots, we notice that it is also tapered or pointed, which is very different from one of your hairs that has a little bulb to keep it in your scalp. You don't want your hairs to come out easily, but porcupines do. Now, we've been looking so far through a dissecting microscope. It's great for things like this that are a little bit thicker and a little bit bigger, and we got a really great view of that. It goes up to about 30 or 40 times larger than life. This is a compound microscope, and this is actually what you'll usually find in your laboratory. It starts at about 40 times larger than life and goes up to 1,000 times larger than life. So it's great to see things that are much smaller. Here you can see the scales as they look through a compound microscope. And over here, you get a pretty good view of that root end and how it's tapered so that it slips out of the porcupine quill, So I hope you enjoyed looking at this through the microscopes. If you've got things that you want to see, feel free to leave your comments in the box below and I will see what I can do. And if you like seeing this stuff, click subscribe and you'll know first when I post a new video. I'll be trying to look at about one or two things per month at least, and hopefully more if you guys like checking things out through the microscopes. So this is Dude with a Microscope saying goodbye till next time.